Hello guys, welcome to my new video, and today we'll be talking about the best healers in World of Warcraft Classic. So we'll be looking at all of the four healing classes that are available, so that includes Druid, Priest, Shaman, and Paladin, and I'll be looking at their performance in high-end game PvE rating. We'll be looking at some of the passes that are available if you're really interested in looking at what healer is gonna help you to reach those top, you know, best logs and things like that, best healing performance, or if you're interested in a healer that's also going to be easy to level, because let's be honest, leveling in Classic is an endeavor in itself, and having a class that's gonna give you an easy time in leveling experience, it's going to be easier to reach that level 60 and start healing in PvE content. So this video is going to be ranking healers at the end as well, based on the performance in Molten Core, because Classic is going to have a staggered raid release where Molten Core and Onyxia are going to be released first. So let's look at healer performance in those raids, and then let's rank healers in terms of which one's the easiest to level. So let's look at a Druid healer first. And if you're watching this video, you might have heard some negative things about Druid healing in the end game PvE Classic content. A lot of the top end or hardcore raiding guilds might only bring one or two druids in order to utilize their utility, and their utility is pretty strong with things like Fairy Fire, which is very, very important for Classic raid composition, because a lot of the raids in Classic will be melee heavy, and this Fairy Fire debuff is going to be a significant DPS boost to your raid. Also, the fact that druids have Innervate, the sad fact is, a Resto Druid, you'll probably be using Innervate on your best Priest healer, because let's be honest, Priest healers are one of the top end healers, and it's going to benefit them the most. So overall, you can see Druid is already some sort of an Innervate bot, but overall they can still do good healing. And at the start, or at least when raiding is going to be open, I think majority of Druid healers are going to be tank healers, because they probably will go with the Swiftman talent build, where you'll be using your healing touch on the tank, and you're going to try and maintain healing over time effects on the tank via your regrowth, which also has the hot component, or rejuvenation, and both of those spells or hots are going to synergize really well with Swiftman. So now you have a Resto Druid who's a good tank healer who can also go raid healing, but you don't really have a designated AoE healing ability, so you kind of have to go, you know, from target to target, maybe regrowing healing touch and things like that. But you also have to consider that Resto Druid is going to have additional utility tools like Battle Res, but Battle Res, which can be used in combat, has like a 30 minute cooldown, has a downside because druids do not have an out of combat res, which means that if you're doing, or at least focusing, 5-man content, you're building your group, you're trying to invite certain classes, you have to invite a class, or at least you have to consider inviting a class that will have an out of combat res, because druids only have Battle Res, which again is a relatively long cooldown. So there is a, you know, downside to it. It's going to be hard to top healing meters as a Resto Druid in Classic WoW, but you have to look at the compromise of being the best leveler. So Resto Druid, at least Druid, will have the easiest time leveling in Classic WoW when compared to all the other healing classes. Druids are arguably one of the best at leveling, maybe to an extent that maybe Warlock or Hunter can be really good as well, but Druids will have an easier time than, let's say, your Paladin. So there is a downside in your PvE endgame rating, but you're going to get to level 60 faster than anybody else. Let's look at priests. And priests, to some extent in Classic WoW, can be viewed as essential healers. They're pretty good, or very good, at single target healing or tank healing, and they're pretty good at AoE healing as well. And to some extent, it's going to depend what you're going to be doing based on whether you're Alliance or Horde, because in Horde, you have Restoration Shamans, or Shamans who are able to do a lot of AoE healing with Chain Heal, and on Alliance, you don't really have that option, and Priest is pretty much like the best option for raid healing. So your role might change based on which faction you play. Also, Priests have this weird race-specific spell. So if you're Alliance, you're most likely going to go with Dwarf Priest, because they have race-specific Fear Ward and Desperate Prayer. Fear Ward can be extremely strong in PvP, also extremely strong on certain raid bosses. So Alliance, Dwarf, Horde, you don't really have that option. But in terms of the healing or the playstyle that they provide, they're pretty good at single target healing. They have a lot of healing options. They have heal, which is very slow but very efficient. They have greater heal, they have flash heal, they have renew as a kind of a hot application. Keep in mind, if you're a designated tank healer, there can only be one renew active on a player, so they usually choose a priest who has the highest like healing potential, and they have that priest keep renew on a tank. So it depends, again, it depends whether you're going to be a tank healer or raid healer. You also have AoE healing with things like Holy Nova and things like Prayer of Healing. Now you have to remember that Prayer of Healing has a restriction because it can only heal your party. So you need to keep an eye on the party health and things like that. A lot of the times it's going to be depending on which rank you're going to be using. Actually, this goes for every single spell that I mentioned. And because of this, priests can be considered as a relatively hard class to master because they have a lot of heals. A lot of their heals are going to be downranked. If you're not sure about downranking, basically means, let's say you're going to be using greater heal and then you might be using a lower rank of greater heal that's going to cost less mana and it's going to heal less. It's still going to add an additional keybind and it's going to make maybe priest a bit more complicated to play, and this goes for a lot of their spells. So there is a relatively high skill ceiling to priests, but they are one of the best raid and single target healers in the game right now, or at least in Classic WoW. They are sought after. You cannot go wrong with a priest in Classic WoW. Let's talk at paladins, and paladins have been notoriously regarded as the easiest healing class in basically Classic, and a lot of people have kind of made an assumption that because Holy Paladin is relatively easy, they might become really boring and things like that. And there is some reasoning behind it. First of all, paladins to some extent can be regarded as one of the best healers in Classic. They are only available to the Alliance side, and because of this, Alliance are going to get specific blessings that make them extremely strong in raiding environments, because paladins can do things like Blessing of Salvation, which is extremely, extremely strong in a high-end tier raiding. They also have specific auras, which are party-wide and can make the party take less damage, maybe some certain resistances and things like that. Again, paladin utility is very, very, very strong, and to some extent it makes Alliance a very good faction for endgame vanilla raiding. If you look at the healing of Holy Paladin or Paladin in general, it's very, very, very simple. Like I said at the start of the video, there's really only three healing spells that you kind of have to look after, and that includes Holy Light, which is going to be your long cast. It's going to heal for a lot, and it's somewhat mana inefficient, so you kind of have to use it when the tank or raid members really need a lot of healing. And then you have Flash of Light, which is extremely efficient, and a lot of paladins will spend a lot of the time using Flash of Light, meaning that paladins become relatively easy to play, and they are very, very mana efficient because of the spells that I mentioned. They also have Holy Shock, which is kind of like a talent that you can choose. Holy Shock can be used in those old trap moments, or basically used when you have to move, because if you're moving, Holy Paladin doesn't have anything to use or anything to heal with during that phase, and Holy Shock can be used for that. But like I mentioned before, paladin utility is incredible, blessings are incredible. You have to look at auras, they're very strong. They have, or at least they're very kind of easy to play because they only have very few spells to use. A lot of them might not even be downranked that many times, so you don't have that many keybinds. But the downside is you don't really have an AoE healing ability at all. The only thing that you really have is Seal of Light, which is not really an AoE healing ability. It's basically a seal that can be applied. Only one seal can be applied per mob. So let's say you have like four paladins in your raid. The one paladin that gets to use that Seal of Light on the boss is going to be straight away the top healer in the raid, because the melee are going to proc it. And again, paladins are going to be fighting for which paladin is going to use this and be looking really good on those healing meters. So to summarize, not a lot of healing spells, easy to play, overall one of the best healers in Classic WoW, amazing utility. There is nothing wrong with playing Paladin in Classic, except for the fact that they're extremely boring and hard to level. So if you can actually get to that level 60, you're going to be one of the top healers in Classic WoW. Now let's talk about shamans, and it's really fun to talk about shamans because they're one of the few healing classes in World of Warcraft that have really good AoE healing spells, and they have chain heal, and it's such an iconic spell, and you can see it bounce from target to target. It's like probably the only one AoE healing spells that are smart heals, and it's really essential to basically why shamans are one of the best raid healers in the game. Now, if you look at the utility that they provide, it is absolutely insane. To some extent, a lot of the utility totems or a lot of the utility buffs that they provide can somewhat be comparable to what paladins provide on the alliance side, because shamans can only, or they're only available on the horde side. So overall, you have a ton of totems in terms of the healing that they provide. In terms of single target healing, you have lesser healing wave, your healing wave, if you want to kind of, you know, make sure your tank is topped up and to deal with tank damage. You can also kind of use your healing abilities to increase the armor of the tank through ancestral healing, so you can kind of do that before the pull, you can do it during the fight and things like that. You can downrank your spells to kind of in hopes to apply it. In terms of AoE healing, chain heal is the king, and it's so goddamn iconic to the whole shaman class fantasy. And in terms of totems, they have some insane totems, and there is also totem twisting, which I'm still not sure whether I like the playstyle, but it's very beneficial to the raid. But I'm not sure if I enjoy the kind of playstyle that it encourages shamans to have. So first of all, you have tons of totems. You have things like Wind Fury totem, you have Strength of Earth totem, which adds strength, you have Tranquil Air totem, which is basically going to reduce the aggro. You have to remember that all of these totems are party wide, so they don't buff the whole raid, just your party. A lot of people will consider it a lesser version of the Salvation buff that is provided, or Salvation Blessing that is provided by paladins. You also have things like, you know, mana totems. So you kind of want to spread out your shamans in groups. Like, you want to make sure shaman is in group 1, shaman is in group 2, group 3, and things like that. So make sure that all of the groups are getting these buffs. And then you have totem twisting. So depending if you're going with the totem build, you're able to place Wind Fury down, and it's going to apply a buff to weapons, to melee weapons for 10 seconds. And then you can apply Grace of Air totem straight away. And then after 10 seconds, or before 10 seconds are about to expire and everyone's gonna lose Wind Fury totem, you apply Wind Fury again, and then you apply Grace of Air. So you're making sure that your melee are getting the maximum amount of DPS boost, and then you're kind of trying to heal in between. Now, this is not mandatory, but I'm pretty sure quite a few shamans will be doing that on fights that do not require that much healing. It is interesting to see that the utility that they can provide, the healing that they can do. So overall, I feel shamans are a very, very good choice, especially if you wanna feel like you're bringing a lot to the raid, to the party, and you're buffing and you're helping people out, especially if you like that AoE healing and the chain heal in the raids. So just to summarize the whole video, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you enjoy this kind of content, please do subscribe and things like that. It really helps out the channel. But if I were to rank healers in high-end PvE raiding, I would have to go something like either Holy Paladin or Priest in rank 1 or tier 1. They're extremely strong. Again, Holy Paladin or Paladin is only available to Alliance, and Priests are available to both factions. So technically, if you're not looking at factions, Priest is probably the best. If you're looking at Alliance, Holy Paladin or Paladin is extremely strong. The utility, their healing, the how mana efficient they are. If I'm looking for the second slot or the rank 3, I would have to go with probably Shaman. Shaman healing might not be, it might be harder to top the healing meters if you want to try be better than your, you know, Holy Paladin, your Priest, and things like that. But shamans provide a ton of utility. Chain heal is really, really fun, and it's probably like the best AoE heal in Classic WoW. And then probably the last healers would probably be Druids, and you kind of can see the little ranking that I have here. And this is kind of showcasing the HBS in Molten Core, which is going to be the first raid that's released when Classic WoW is released. So you can kind of look at the HPS. It's not always the best way to determine which healer is going to top the meters, but Druid is definitely, it's kind of hard to find a Druid at the top healing meters. So keep that in mind. And if I were to look at the leveling ranking, by far the best leveling class in this video or at least mentioned in this video, will be Druid. Druid is very, very good class to level 60. If we're looking at the second or the third spot, honestly, very interchangeable, Priest or Shaman, somewhere along there. They're very, very close in terms of, in my opinion, in terms of how fast they're going to level to level 60. And by far the worst from this video is Paladin. Paladin is going to take a long time and it's going to be quite boring in my opinion. I'm always open to suggestions. I might have missed on something. And if you would like to see more classic videos, leave a comment below. Let me know what video you would want to see next. Thank you guys, and I'll see you in my next guide.